coming back to him is great because you go, well, how far will he go this time? Where will hope lead him to? What terrible things will it make him do? And how will he somehow rationalize what he is doing? Ahriman Undying is a follow-up to Ahriman Eternal, and it starts where you might not expect it to, with Ahriman having actually lost his warband, all of his followers, from them having been taken over by this presence called the Pyrodaimon, him having apparently also lost in this battle against a Necron Faeron. Really, it's a mystery story in some ways about how on earth this happened and then what he can do to unravel that and hopefully save his legion from this new doom that is trying to destroy them from within and trying to defeat this incredibly intelligent ancient Necron called Setek. Ahriman's plan to save his legion at this point is something that he has to figure out. He doesn't actually know how he's going to do it at this point. But one of the things that he was searching for is this device that allows you to manipulate time. The Necrons have chronometron technology that allows them to, on a limited basis, rewind time. And he is searching for a larger one of these devices. He apparently has failed at the beginning of this book. But as becomes clear throughout the book, whenever anything that involves the manipulation of time is concerned, what appears to be happening might not actually be what is happening. And in that lies the answer to how he might be able to get out of this problem. This book was incredibly fun to write. I love writing things that have mind-bending, time-switching aspects to it. And this book is, to be honest, laced with them. You have intersecting timelines, different visions of past and future. It includes the Harlequins, who are operating according to their own prediction and manipulation of the future based on their great cycles. So you get them and you get to see how they perceive things. You have the Necrons, who are also perceiving exactly the same set of circumstances from their point of view and how they wage war basically across time. And then you have the Thousand Sons and Ahriman, who are also trying to do all of these things from the point of view of incredibly powerful sorcerers whose minds also are almost existing within the warp as much as they are their bodies. It's mind-bending stuff. But ultimately, really, it's a story about power, the limits of power, and hubris. You've got these two characters, Setek and Ahriman, who one of them is a Necron Faeron who believes that he alone has the power to change the past and should have the right to dominate the future. You have Ahriman, this incredibly powerful Thousand Sun sorcerer, who believes that only he sees clearly and only he can create a future for his legion. So there's no similarities there at all between the two of them. And really, all of the time shenanigans aside, it's really about how those two incredible intelligences and incredibly arrogant individuals clash and which one comes out on top. I think the best thing about Ahriman is that he keeps on lying to himself. That's the most intriguing thing about him. He keeps on telling this lie that he can make it right, that there is hope for him, for the Thousand Sons, that there is this way back from all of the misfortunes that have been piled on them. And that's what makes him intriguing, because that hope never runs out. So it leads him down these increasingly desperate attempts to undo the past, to make the future right. And because he is Ahriman, some of those are incredibly extreme. His first attempt was the rubric. The second attempt was to recast the rubric. This attempt is to rewrite time. They're not small things. So coming back to him is great because you go, well, how far will he go this time? Where will hope lead him to? What terrible things will it make him do? And how will he somehow rationalize what he is doing to himself, apart from also the rest of his legion?